So, we're going to make a pedalboard. In the past, what I've used is this Pelican IM2500 case, and I've had a piece of Perspex with my rack looper on top of it, and then some pedalboards, pedals velcroed on top of that. But it's starting to warp the case off the looper, so I'm taking the looper out and I'm making a proper pedalboard. So what I've done is I've bought some plywood from the hardware store. They'll cut it up for you, hopefully, usually. So this is marine clay. It's more rock resistant and usually higher quality. This is double A quality, which is good if you're going to be, especially if you're going to be stomping on it. I'm not going to do that because I can use my hands. So I've got that cut to size where it's really snug in here. So there's no movement at all when we fly. A little bit of padding, but ideally, less movement is better than lots of padding. So we're going to cover this in some black paint primer so that it doesn't warp over time or rot, and then some carpet so the Velcro pedals will stick to it, and a couple of handles to carry it in and out, lift it in and out as well. Edges with a rasp, wood rasp, and then just sand everything, sand the corners and the edges so it's nice and smooth. Roughen it up a little bit for the primer and then paint it. Now I'm going to wipe it down with a damp rag to get the dust off it, but not a wet rag, so I don't want to soak the wood. Then we're going to paint the board with a flat black acrylic primer and coat in one, or they call it paint and prime. So the advantage of using spray paint is it's quick to dry, quick to touch, and it's not as thorough, it doesn't soak into the wood as well as if you were using a paintbrush, but really this thing isn't going to be in high kind of heavy duty use. So I think it's going to be okay. We'll get back to you in 10 years if it doesn't work. We're going to paint it with a flat black acrylic paint now. Paint it and prime it in one so it seals the wood, stops it from warping, and makes a good base for us to then glue the carpet onto. Painting with spray can, it's best to start off the surface and finish off the surface so you don't get a big blob of paint where you start off, where you first press the trigger. So you want to go like this and finish. Okay, this is relatively dry to touch now. So I've got some run-of-the-mill black industrial carpet from the hardware store. Check that my Velcro sits on it really well. And then cut that to size, and then I'm going to use some spray adhesive on each surface and stick it on. Almost the right size, but I'm going to trim it back a couple of mils on each edge. I'm going to use a piece of steel or a ruler for that. Then I'm going to round the corners a little bit. Cool. Different camera angle. Professional. Okay, so the board has dried. The glue for the carpet on the board is set, and the paint is pretty much dry. It's not sticky, tacky anymore. So now what I'm going to do is get a couple of cupboard handles from the hardware store, again, if you're detecting a bit of a theme. These are just going to go on the board here and here, so I can lift it in and out of the Pelican case. So the pedalboard's done. I gave it another couple of coats of paint overnight, so it was a bit more durable. And everything's looking good. The carpet's stuck down nice and firm. The handles are solid. And the whole thing weighs maybe 200 or 300 grams, so it's perfect for flying. No extra weight. I could have bought a metal pedalboard, but I'm losing about that much height inside my case. And it's really not necessary. This thing's as solid as. So what I would probably do with my pedals, again, I'm going to stack a couple of them because I can do that, because I can use my hands when I'm performing. But we've got the delay, the reamping box, or the radial voco loco, the pedal I made to control my loopers. We've got the power supply and the Alesis Nanoverb, nice little quarter rack reverb over here. And room for an octave pedal and possibly some other things. If I was really going to cram it up, I could probably fit one or two more pedals in here. So if I put this up here, it'll all fit in the Pelican case. So that should just slide down into the Pelican case here, like that. I've got a little bit of foam falling off. Cool. That's good, that's nice and firm. And what I'll do now is I'm just going to cut some blocks of foam and restick them to the walls of this case with some heavy-duty double-sided tape, again from the hardware store, and glue some new foam in here as well with some better tape. And this thing doesn't move at all that way. It's got a bit of give this way, but the foam should take care of that. And yeah, I could easily go up another level of pedals as well, but this is good for me. This is nice and safe. So I hope that was useful for you, and good luck on your own build.